Hey everyone! In this video, we'll be going over image replacement in the Variable Data Wizard. We will use a tab delimited Excel file to control text and image placement in the creation of a series of badges. To successfully use image replacement, the images should have the same dimensions. You will also need to have access to the images and know the path to the file location. This path will be used in the data file that points VDW to the images. In this example, we're going to replace the name and photo for each visitor. With the badge file loaded in the queue, right-click on the job and select Variable Data Wizard. Once the badge is loaded into VDW, we'll want to indicate where the name and photo of each visitor will be placed. Starting with the name and using the text tool found on the left toolbar, click and draw a marquee under the image. This will indicate where the visitor's name will go. The text box will constrain any text to within the boxed area. To set up the text for the name, change the font to Arial, set the font height to 0.24 inches, and give it center justification. Now we'll type the words visitor's name. Next, we'll place the image that will represent the size and position of the visitor photos for the badges. Select the image placement tool found midway down the toolbar on the left. This will open a dialog where you will navigate to the location of the image you plan to use to set the placement on the badges. You can use common image formats such as BMP, JPEG, PNG, EPS, and PDF. For this example, the format of the images will be JPEG. They have been previously collected in a folder on my C drive. Select the first image. It's not important which image is selected because the images will be controlled using the XML file. The cursor will now become a right angle. Click where the top left of the image should start on the badge. This image represents the size and location of all the images to be used in this job. For this badge, the image needs to be scaled to 1.58 inches wide. Before scaling, ensure the Two Fit Radio button is selected. This ensures all other images will be scaled to fit within the dimensions of this image. Set the horizontal size to 1.58. The vertical value will change proportionally. Position the image to the right of the logo. It can be precisely positioned using the horizontal position or X value and vertical position or Y value found in the smart bar. For this image, an X value of 3.85 and a Y value of 1.15 works best. With the name and image placeholders created and in position, we can now replace them by using the Variable Data Wizard. Click on the Variable Data Wizard icon in the toolbar to the left. Tick the Replace Data File box in the top left of the dialog. Click Browse to navigate to the file containing the data replacement information. The Variable Data Wizard can import a number of file formats, such as text, tab delimited text, ODS, OpenOffice spreadsheet, Excel files, Excel workbooks, and CSV text files. In our case, the data was saved from Excel, so we'll set it to Excel file when searching. We'll select it and click Open. The number of entries in the file is automatically recognized, which in this example is 12. Now change the function setting for visitor name and graphic from None to Replace and click Next. The following dialog allows you to create custom material output sizes for the badges, but we'll keep the badges at their original size. Click Next. You now see the text substitution dialog. Here are the columns representing the visitor's name and the visitor's picture. This matches the order of the data used on the badge. With the columns in the right order, click OK. The badges are now automatically created and loaded as print jobs in the queue, with the names and photos in place as outlined on the template. They are now ready to be printed on a flatbed printer or any other device that might need exact positioning, such as garment printers, UV printers, or laser engravers. Thanks for watching! If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please reach out to us at any time. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering all of CADLINK's products.